Yeah, hi, we were just ending our internal tech meeting, productivity tech meeting here, and one of the topics that came up that Kelly said you wanted me to riff on for a minute is just clean edges. And the fascinating thing that everybody wants to know, how do I use the PDA? Which one works best for GTD? And what's the best little cool tool for this? And I understand that because the strange paradoxes with all of this is that the less the tool matters, in other words, the more you really get the methodology of GTD, the more the tool matters. It's like, yeah, it doesn't matter what the tool is, but now the tool I've got, I want to really understand how to use it to its max. And I understand that. The other side and the other paradox is people go, well, look, the tool will help me do GTD because I don't really get GTD and I'm not really doing it yet. So hopefully the tool will make it work. And I think that's another attraction people have to wait, what's the best one? How does that work? Unfortunately, most of the tools and most of the ways people are trying to use the tools, they're conceptually great and cool because you think about all these features that would be really nice, but if the content that you put into these is not complete and consistent, then you ultimately the motivation to input and to use it will die away. So that's really the majority of the usage of these things. They're not really shelfware, but they're sort of pocketware. It's kind of like I got it in there, but and it was such a cool idea on that Saturday when I set it up and all those neat things to do. But if I have to keep doing that, then what happens is it's too much trouble to stick it all in there. I have to think too much to get it in, and then the lists start to be incomplete. And when they're incomplete, some part of you says, I'm not really getting the payoff. And it's not a real conscious thing. I think people subliminally just realize, look, my head's still going to have to be my system anyway, and it's just too much trouble to then go input into the system. And so that's why these things die away very, very rapidly when they start to die away. As soon as the lists get incomplete or out of date, you're not motivated to keep inputting, and then it becomes less in date and less consistent, and it just falls away. It's just not worth it. So that's really a lot of the syndrome that's going on. So it's a strange thing that you almost like you have to have such clean edges to the boundaries, and everything needs to go in there. As soon as you start to spread it out into lots of different ways, trying to use all the different aspects of the technology, that's where you run into real danger zone that stuff is going to spread out, not be consistent and complete, be too much trouble to keep it all up, and the whole thing will crash and burn.